Hey you and welcome. I'm Mr. Barry. In this whole video I want to talk about the SwiftU PDF editor. I'm going to go over its features, how to use it, and its pricing, as well as whether I recommend it or not. Hey, let's look at this PDF editor, you and I. Come on. So here we are in the Windows desktop. Now I've gone to swiftu.com. And it's the all-in-one free PDF software here. And it is free for 30 days. If you want to use it beyond 30 days, well, that's when you have options to purchase it. And there's a monthly, you can go by month or by year or even buy it outright there. And I'll talk more about the pricing there towards the end on that page. The ultimate solutions for your PDF documents. So SwiftU enables you to create, convert, merge, compress, and sign PDF documents all in a blink of an eye. To download it, you just simply click on the free download either here or towards the top here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to click on free download and just show you that real quick. And it will save it into your downloads folder, so just click on save. And then you'll be able to see it down here. Let's go ahead and install it. Now click on install now. You'll install in a few seconds, and after that, new window will open up and click on start now. And when it opens, it actually opens up into the how to use the SwiftU PDF editor. And it actually has a PDF document that we can actually experiment with and actually learn how to do everything with. So let's look at some of the features that we have now. First off is edit. So it allows you to edit everything just as you would a Microsoft Word document. SwiftU PDF's powerful editing feature enables you to modify the PDF's document as easily as a Microsoft Word file. Open a PDF with SwiftU PDF and then click edit in the tab and then edit to start making changes to the content. We strongly recommend users to adopt this method when it comes to editing a part of the PDF. Now please note that scanned PDFs, also known as image-only PDFs, cannot be edited and thus are not searchable. So you'd click on this button right here to edit it. And another feature is annotate. Now multiple annotation tools for enhanced interactivity. So you see here, actually change the text within your PDF. You may compress the file, so a smaller file size for faster file transfer and smoother collaboration. There you go, you compress. Merge or split, so file combination or separation for consistent information sharing and distribution. You can convert, so you can convert a one type of file such as PDF to one of these others such as Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or even an image or a scanned copy, and you have other options as well. Now you're all able to take a Word document or even a Google document and then convert that into a PDF as well too, and allows you to incorporate a watermark, which is really nice, and you're allowed to sign it as well. So let's go in and let's actually start looking at some of the tools that we have up here. Notice that you have the way to change the zooming size up here, which is kind of nice. You can rotate it, add a different theme, or even search the document. So let's go to edit, and once we're in edit here, let's actually click on edit and start editing some of these words here. So let's just say that I wanted to add something, so I can click on here and let's add this. So that was very easy to add text to the document. If I wanted to take something out, like this sentence here, look at that, just highlight and backspace or delete, and it takes those out. So that's very easy to do that. If I wanted to change the text in here, maybe I want to change the color, make it red, that's easy to do there. And Control Z will allow me to undo that. And so within here, you notice that we can insert new text. We can even do white out. So let's try that out. Let's try white here. And let's highlight some of this and just take it out. Look at that. It takes it out. We can hit Control Z again to undo that. Let's choose a different color. Well, if I want to choose blue and highlight things in blue there. There you go. Now we can make that any shape that we want. And again, Control Z would take that out. Next we have insert image. So let's click that. And we have different images here. Let's say I wanted to insert this image here. Click it there and inserts the image. Now what's nice about this is if you click on the image, you actually have image tools where you can rotate it. So let's rotate this. If I didn't like that, Control Z will bring it back. And if I didn't like it at all, I could hit the backspace or the delete key and remove it entirely. So that's really nice. Let's change the background, see what that does. When I click on there, we can add a different background and we can have a different color or even an image for a background. So there's many different options there for placing in a background. This is another way to insert a watermark as well. So we'll just cancel that. We can do a link or hyperlink to another file or to something else there on the internet, such as an image or another PDF on the internet. We can crop. We can do a page setup where we actually change the margin and the paper size there, so that's all within the page setup. And the next one is split page. That's where we can actually split the page into multiple pages there. And the desk view here is actually allows me to go in and rotate the image there. So if you scanned in an image and it wasn't quite perfect, you can basically change the rotation to make it exactly perfect there for you. And the very last tool that I want to talk about is the OCR. The OCR allows the computer to actually read text that's found within an image. So it is possible to read and edit images there if you have text in it. And that's what the OCR function is all about. Let's go in and see what else we have here. So what I'm going to do is click on View Now. And that's where we see the very first tab, where we can change the viewing of our document. Annotate is where we can actually change the text or images within the PDF. There's that edit again. And then we have convert, where we can convert a PDF to a Word, Excel, PowerPoint, or an image, or many other options there. If I go click on page, this is where we actually see the different pages, where we can split, extract, or insert new pages into our PDF. So there's many different options that we have there. And we even have an option there for the page number, which I kind of like there. We have advanced, and advanced basically allows me to do encryption, which is really handy. If you only want certain people to see your document, you can encrypt it. You can add a watermark. There's your background again, which is similar to watermark. You can add your signature. And you have other options that you see here. For sharing, it's very easy to share within your Google Drive, your Dropbox, send it as an email. So there's many different options there for sharing your documents with others. And the last tab that we have is the help. So let me click on that and notice that we have the ability to actually go in there. And when we go into it, that's when we open up into the user guide. There's your user guide. We can update it, send feedback, or look at the shortcut keys. And here's the list of the shortcut keys, which really comes in handy. The very first one that I like to teach my students is Control Z, and that's to undo or cancel. And it does remember multiple operations. If you want to go in and print to Microsoft Word document, that's Alt P. And there's many other shortcuts there. Many of them overlap to other apps such as Control C, which is to copy, or select or highlight all is Control A. So these are basically used for many different applications. Let's go ahead and let's close that off. Wow! Hey, SwiftDude PDF is an awesome program. So we've gone over how to install it, a quick tutorial of the features, and actually using those features to edit a PDF document. Now, as promised, I am going to go over the pricing. So there's the pricing as they are March 2022. And you notice there's three different ways to go about this. One is by buying it by the month, another is by buying it by the year, or buying it forever. And as you see there, there's the different prices. $119 if you buy it forever. And that would probably be the one that I would recommend going with, because, well, you get to use it forever. And if you're a person who really goes in there, maybe you're a student or you're working in the office, or even if you're a teacher like I am, we often work with PDF documents and we have to edit PDF documents. One of the nice features about SwiftDo PDF is it allows you to rotate the PDF document. So let's say you scanned it in and it wasn't quite perfect, quite square. You can actually go in with the desk view and actually rotate it a little bit to make it perfect. And that is a feature that really you don't find very often in many other PDF editors. So the big question here is, do I recommend it? And the answer is yes, I recommend it for teachers or other people who are working with PDF documents and stuff like that. And hey, if you do have a question or a comment, leave that down there in the comment section and I'll try to get to it as soon as I can. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe to my channel, SelmaTeacher7. And I also want to say, please click on thumbs up too if you like these types of videos. Also, I wanted to say thank you to all those who have been sharing my videos on their social media sites. I really appreciate that and all the effort that you do put in as far as sharing my videos and also the support that you've given. Thank you very much, and you all have a very good day. Bye-bye.